Hi, this is Josh Stern.
And Michael Walters.
Yeah, we're with the Millionaire Agent Mindset tip of the day. Today's tip is creating the perfect real estate schedule. So these are tips and tricks that I've learned before and after creating my own millionaire agent business and coaching for MAPS, literally some of the top real estate teams in the entire world. And I offer these to you in an effort to fulfill our purpose of helping others to achieve their own greatness potential. Okay, this is gonna sound kooky, but let me first suggest that when you start your morning every day, I would start with some I am statements like I am successful, or I am a powerful negotiator, or simply start the day by saying, this is the best day ever. You see, your brain is like a CPU in a computer. What you put into it is how you program it. And you probably know that what you focus on expands. The emotional highs and lows are what really gets in the way of the best day ever. And how do we solve for this problem? You see, there's so much drama when you don't design your day. Probably already heard this statement, if you don't make a plan, you become a part of someone else's plan. So think about it. If you gotta go on a trip and you have 24 hours to get it all together, you'll create a perfect list, pack, you're gonna make all your calls and simply get things done to feel fulfilled before you leave. If your business is slow, do yourself a favor. Book a trip, it'll make you productive.
Yeah, so let's focus on what we know. The schedule matters. Designing your day before the day starts is how we get it done on good foot.
Yeah.
If it isn't in your schedule, it doesn't exist. And do yourself a favor and schedule the things that matter most first. In this case, we know that you need to have in your schedule time to practice scripts, time to lead generate, and time to lead follow-up to ensure a full pipeline of clients and new appointments. You also want to be specific with whom you're going to follow up with. For instance, you might decide to make 10 sphere of influence contacts using one particular script, then switch to the lead follow-up from the prior weekend open houses, then turn on the follow-up for the leads already in the hopper. Maybe they're internet leads or past leads that simply need to be warmed up. Either way, practice the scripts for that and make that call.
Great idea. What Michael is saying is the reason most people don't do lead follow-up is that they simply lack an effective script and don't know what to say, and that's why scripting is one of the things that matters most.
Yep. If you need help, a great lead follow-up script, give me a call.
Yeah, you see, it's been scientifically proven that your willpower is not on will call. What do I mean by that? Well, it takes a lot of energy to use your brain, and we have most of our mental energy in the morning hours. Therefore, do the hardest tasks first while you have willpower. For most in real estate, that's going to be scripting and making phone calls. And this might go back to how you start your morning to ensure that you have mental fortitude to get through the calls. If you haven't read Miracle Morning, by the way, I'd recommend it. It goes into depth into what some of the most successful people, business folk do as a morning routine to make their own great day great. And think affirmations, the I am statements that I had mentioned right at the beginning of this video. Try journaling with a focus on daily gratitude as well as daily goals. Get to the gym early and after or before the gym, try meditating or prayer to calm your mind and allow some space between reaction and reality. A commonplace drama, you know, tends to show up. And then you follow that up with something nutritious for your body and do this all before 8 a.m.
Yeah, get in the office by 8:15 to 8:30 and practice scripts with a role play partner for 30 minutes. Then hop right in onto the phone with a focus of making 25 contacts. This will take you between 2 to 3 hours to accomplish, and we don't open the door for sales until after 11 a.m. on our team. And that's because we're busy calling our pipeline from 8:30 till 11 a.m. each day. I would focus on having my appointments at 1:30, 3:30, or 5:30, which left me from 11 to 1 to prepare for appointments and negotiate contracts. In the event you don't have an appointment booked for one of those slots, use the time to work on your business, to better understand what's working on your business versus working in your business. Please watch the video blog with the same title.
Yeah, thanks very much for that. And if you have any specific questions, feel free to give Michael or myself a call. We'd love to talk with you.